The country famous for its fish and chips, a real-life royal family with all its fanfare and the Big Ben, is also home to elite universities that double up as centuries-old relics. The United Kingdom, the head state for England, Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland, is a major hotspot for tourism as well as education. There are approximately 500,000 international students in the pursuit of higher education in the UK. England hosts the most number, followed by Scotland and the rest. And as usual, China and India top the charts when it comes to the highest number of student imports there. Included among those are some of the brightest minds in business education at some of the best business schools in the world. What makes the UK an excellent choice for business education? What are the benefits of getting an MBA from the UK? Which are the best business schools to target? What does it take to get into a top MBA in the UK? After searching for the answers to these questions, if you're feeling knackered or you've got your knickers in a twist, this video is for you. An MBA from the UK offers several benefits. First off, the names Cambridge and Oxford are synonymous with a history of excellence. So are the London School of Economics, the London Business School, Manchester University, you name it. Over 10% of the top 100 MBA programs in the world are from the UK. These are not just good business schools, but global brand names respected in both academic and professional circles. Each year, GMAT, the company that owns GMAT, surveys the number of score reports by geography, including how many score reports are sent to a country. The popularity of a UK MBA is evident from the GMAT scores sent to the UK in the recent years. Despite the instability introduced by the Brexit vote, the number of scores sent in the past couple of years haven't reduced from about 5 years ago, before Brexit. In fact, non-European Union score reporting had an unexpected increase in applications. From 3.8% in 2016, it went up to 4.4% in 2017. Clearly, whatever fear Brexit may have induced among the immigrant population, UK MBA aspirants were quite unfazed by it. Global stalwarts like Cambridge and Oxford have enough might to hold off against the massive political changes that could possibly affect future jobs. But there's also some good news on the topic of work permits after MBA, which we'll cover a little later. Here's a list of the best business schools and MBA programs in the UK that regularly feature in the top 100. Though the cost of an MBA in UK can be steep, between $40,000 to $75,000, most UK MBA programs are only a year long. This provides an added advantage to make good on the opportunity cost of getting a two-year MBA degree from USA. UK also has some of the major financial centers of the world. London, for instance, provides massive networking opportunities for cashing in on the MBA ROI. The typical expenses in the UK depend on the city housing the university. Here's the monthly cost of living in the UK for some popular cities. International students are allowed up to 20 hours of part-time on-campus jobs and full-time jobs during holidays. This can help in relieving the financial stress, especially for MBA students with heavy student debts. The caveat is to understand how to balance the MBA workload with a part-time job without compromising the quality of learning. This is why students at the top MBA programs with a rigorous schedule are unable to work while studying. Let's talk about life in the UK as an international student. One major advantage for internationals is UK's highly cosmopolitan nature. While that gives international students a cozy, home away from home feeling, communicating in the Queen's language makes it easy to transition into the country. You know, cause the English are known to speak in English. So no need to squint through Google Translate to order a cup of tea. Let's move on to the work visa and permanent residency after an MBA in the UK. This is one of the biggest perks of studying here. Compared to the one-year OPT in the United States, UK has very recently become quite generous with the duration of work authorization permit after graduating from a recognized UK institution. The post-study work visa, or the graduate route, is open to all international undergrad or above students at an approved UK higher education provider. It'll begin with the intake of 2020 and 2021 students. The visa allows eligible students to work or hunt for work in any career or position for 2 years after completing studies, according to the UK government's website. In addition, the UK has also opened up fast-track visa options for scientists. It is committed to increasing the cap limit of PhDs entering the skilled work visa path. In simpler words, the UK is aiming to become a STEM hub, which in turn means students of STEM-designated programs will have better chances of finding long-term employment and a position that can help them get into the skilled work visa system. Permanent resident status is automatic after living and working in the UK for at least 5 years. Coming to the eligibility requirements, most UK MBA programs, like anywhere else, follow the same recipe to judge the MBA readiness of its applicants. And they do so by monitoring some or all of the application criteria as sampled from various top B schools in the UK. GMAT or GRE score. These standardized test scores are used to compare candidates against a baseline. Typical GMAT scores, even in the top programs, are in the 680 to 700 range. Almost none mention a minimum requirement, but their generally accepted competitive score is over 650. As for GRE, a score of over 160 for both verbal and quantitative is considered competitive. An English language proficiency test may not be necessary if the applicant has a degree where the medium of instruction has been English, though this concession really depends on the program. Typical proficiency tests accepted include TOEFL, IELTS, Cambridge CPE, CAE or PTE academic scores. When it comes to undergrad degree, the usual good academic pedigree is a requirement no matter where you apply, though anyone with a low GPA can also explore as long as their profile is otherwise strong. A minimum of 2 years of work experience is usually expected, though the average is about 6 years. The details are program dependent, but the quality of previous employment should be able to demonstrate leadership, and applicants should be able to add to the classroom richness through their global experiences. The rest of the application requirements would include MBA essays, reference or recommendation letters, a CV, and interviews. What about jobs after MBA in the UK? The UK has been featured as the fifth highest payer for MBA degree holders, with average salaries and bonus close to $122,000. Here's a list of the average salaries after an MBA from the top UK B schools. Most of the reputed ones have excellent career services and resources. For instance, London Business School collaborates with recruiters to design its MBA curriculum, fully loaded to train students with the most relevant skills. Not surprisingly, over 90% of the MBA graduates manage to find a lucrative job offer within 3 months of graduation. Is an MBA from the UK worth it? Excellent schools, globally recognized brands, multinational employers with highly competitive salaries and responsibilities, significant networking opportunities, outstanding student resources, and a much shorter MBA duration. All this makes UK MBA programs a force to be reckoned with. Add to these the chance of establishing a permanent residency within the UK and easy access to the European Union, and you get a highly worthwhile international business education opportunity. At MBA Crystal Ball, we have some of the best MBA admission consultants. For London Business School, Cambridge Judge, Oxford Saïd, and the other top MBA programs in the UK. If you need professional help with your MBA applications, drop us an email. Good luck to you.